Hey guys, Kevin Ryan here with XUFN.com, XUFNGaming.com, and of course, it's E3 Day Zero. Okay, it doesn't officially start till tomorrow, but a lot of the big pressers were held today. Microsoft, Ubisoft, Sony, most of the pressers today. Tomorrow is, I won't give a winner as far as pressers go, because tomorrow's 9 a.m. is Nintendo's. So I'll give them a fair shot. I'm expecting some big things from them. At least I hope so. Because, well, they need it bad. They cannot live on Mario Kart alone. Almost, but not quite. Still, haven't been talking to the camera for a while. The Halo is going to be huge next year. Obviously, with Halo 5 coming out early 2015. Or is it December? Anyway. They're going to have Halo Anniversary, Halo 2 Anniversary, which is announced today, given the anniversary treatment. So they've taken the graphics up a notch. They look beautiful. Halo 3 and Halo 4 in one package with a beta for Halo 5. That is going to sell huge. I know I'm looking forward to it. I'm not even that huge into Halo. I've enjoyed it, but to get all in one package... Yes, please. One disc for all that. I wonder how much of that they'll have to download, too, for all the additions. But, hey, they fit all on one disc. Pretty awesome. Okay, sorry, it's my head's the bright light. I only have one light on. Still affecting a little, so I'm squinting. I feel a lot better sitting out at my desk, getting some work done. Pressers, all good. Ubisoft had, the main thing of the day was Assassin's Creed Unity. Looked amazing. Far Cry 4 looks amazing. Lots and lots of sequels. Like Uncharted 4, which, all the stuff, the early stuff, they just show you the CGI stuff. Looks cool. Like Dead Island 2, remember Dead Island 1 CGI? The trailer for it? Looked amazing. The game? Promising, but no, didn't live up to its potential. The trailer for Dead Island 2 looks amazing. Like, really amazing. But I'm not going to fall for it. Show me some gameplay. Actually, let me get my hands on it before I commit any hype to it like I did for the first one. Because more likely it will have nothing to do with the series. It's trailer magic. So, E3... Today was just a general presser day. The actual game floor stuff will be for the next 3 days. But today, the presser's a lot of great stuff, like PlayStation TV coming out. $99 or $139 with a DualShock Lego City game download, Lego the Movie download, and an 8GB card. So that's something I'm actually quite interested in, because with the... $99 for PlayStation TV by itself, not great. But if you throw a DualShock and the game and the SD card in, the value's there. So, I'll definitely be talking about more as I get my hands on one. But it's the price point's right. Not sure what $99 for it by itself, but with the additions for just $39 more, seems right. I'm all about value, a.k.a. I'm cheap. Yeah, it's late. I've been watching the streams all day long. My head almost felt like it exploded a few times. But it was a good day for gaming. I don't care if you're Nintendo, Sony, Xbox, or PC. Gamers won today. There is so much variety coming. Little Big Planet 3... looks amazing. Grand Theft Auto 5 coming to Xbox One, PlayStation 4, and PC. So I can't wait to see the graphics on that. They show a little bit of in PlayStation 4 graphics, and it looks sharp. Hopefully they can actually live up and give us the stuff they promised for the last-gen consoles, like heists and stuff. But I know I'm excited to get high def. No Last of Us. I mean, Last of Us Remastered is is on the way and looks sharp. Yeah, not too many bad parts. And I've rambled on. Just wanted a quick little 5-minute update of the day. Lots of great gaming stuff. I'll have a breakdown tomorrow with more specific details. But I just want to get this up tonight. And in the title card, there will be a code for a free Humble Bundle. So grab it and have a great night.